in our concerts to say a few words about our instruments. So if you guys would have to take a moment and introduce. These instruments are really rare. You don't really see them around very much. This lute has a 4 years waiting period. So you get to know your luthier, you pay, and then you hope that you know he'll be well and for about 4 years and have a good health and steady hands. Lutes are introduced to European music in about 13th or 14th century, during the times of Crusade years. Original instrument that was popular in the Middle East was called the oud, and it kind of has a similar shape, but it had five courses of strings, and it was played with a sort of a something looks like a, that looks like a guitar pick. And that was perfect for the music of that region that was mainly monophonic. And then when troubadours in southern France have seen that instrument, they decided that they need to adjust it, adopt it to their music that they're playing that was already kind of a polyphonic music. And so what they did is they added more strings and they put a frets on, which oud did not have, and then they throw away that pick and start playing with their fingers. And that's how the Renaissance lute was born. It was probably the most popular instrument during the time of the Renaissance, and a lot of music is written for that. For lute and lute and voice also, you have seen a few. The instrument that Nelly plays looks quite different. But actually the way the sound is made is very similar. It looks more like a piano, but the mechanism of sound production is more like a lute, because this key, it has a little lever at which end is a little quill, like a pick that plucks the strings, and it does it always the same way. So that's the difference between this and the piano. When the piano was invented, it was a big deal, like you can play loud, you can play soft. This instrument has a problem of sustained notes, so oftentimes harpsichords are trying to use a lot of ornaments and trills to kind of make the notes last kind of longer. Okay, something like having a they do these little things, little trills. So that's about the lute and harpsichord and. Oliver knows a lot about percussion, and he is using different kinds of percussion, so he'll tell you a little bit about that.
So this here is called it's known as the frame drum out here in Western world, but it has many names. It's one of the oldest percussion instruments in the world, actually. It's found in pretty much almost every culture in different ways, even the Native American Indians have this. But in Europe, the Irish use it, the Buron, and it's been around in Europe. But, a lot of the history, like in Europe, like he was saying, the instrument came from the Middle East originally. So did some of the percussion instruments. They came originally from the Middle East, especially this. And now this is, you may call it a tambourine, if I ask you. But this is the origins to the tambourine. It's called a rek, and it's a Middle Eastern instrument used in like Arabic music and stuff. That's the origin to this, the tambourine. But it's played very differently. It's, you use a lot of fingers and...
Thank you.
rock and roll like this.
This is the viola di gamba, and it looks kind of like a cello. This has six strings normally, and they come in a family of instruments. They have a small one about the size of a violin. They have a medium one. They have the treble, the tenor, and then this is the bass viola di gamba. This one happens to have seven strings. And it also has frets. It's tuned kind of like a guitar. It's tuned in fourths, and then we have one third in the middle. And of course, the reason I'm sitting tuning all the time is because it's strung up with gut strings. And the gut strings don't like the change of temperature. They like it cold or hot or humid, but if it changes, it just drives us crazy. And so I'll be tuning a lot. I guess its origins came kind of from the lute, some people would say, and it was kind of tuned the same way. It's the same thing with frets. And the frets also move around, you can move them to tune them. And this is actually the predecessor of the modern day double bass. The double bass is not a member of the violin family, it's a member of the viola di gamba family. Any questions? Strings, during that time period, it was bad luck to kill cats. And so they told everybody that we made the string without cat yet. So no one else could get into the business. They're actually made of sheep yet.
So I'm a violin player, so you're probably familiar with this. So the earliest stringed instruments in history were plucked like the lute. And the idea of using horsehair and a bow on the strings to vibrate the strings probably came from the nomadic equestrian cultures of Central Asia. And then so that eventually evolved into this, which is a lot more ergonomic. We think that the violin was probably invented around the 16th century. The first painting that we know of with violins in it was around 1530 in Italy. That's around the time that this music was composed, so that's cool. But nowadays the violin is used. It's a pretty important instrument for a lot of genres. Orchestral music, obviously, chamber music, bluegrass, folk, country, all that. So, yay, violin.
Traverso, very soft instrument. a common instrument in Irish music and an English song.
Okay, so we'll continue our journey. Europe, and let's see if you can guess which country we are going to now. We are playing the tune, it's called La Spagna.